In this video, I'm going to show you how to manage images in the all-new Adobe Captivate. I'm Paul Wilson, and I make YouTube videos about e-learning, specifically Adobe Captivate. If you like what I'm doing here, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and by all means, share this video with any of your e-learning buddies. So I had a viewer reach out to me and they wrote just a quick question on my YouTube channel here saying, do you know if there's a list of recommended image sizes to use in the all new Adobe Captivate for some of the image template defaults that they have? And I'll answer it this way. I'll say that I don't think there's a specific size that you should be shooting for, but I think what I'll do is I'll just share with you my process of dealing with images. So let's take a look at my screen here. I just downloaded this background image here and I'm gonna right click on it and select properties right here. You can see that this image is 4.40 megabytes or 4.6 megabytes, depending on how you wanna read that. And by itself, that's not that large. Like when we think about large, we think about gigabytes or terabytes. We certainly don't think about megabytes any longer. But here's the thing. In a typical e-learning course, you're not going to have one image used over and over again. You're going to have dozens of images, sometimes 50 to 100 images in a typical e-learning course. And so if you take that number and multiply it by, let's say, 100, you know, your 4 megabyte image suddenly is impacting your project file times 100 and could be 400 megabytes, which is quite large for an e-learning course. Anything consumed on the web, you want obviously to optimize it here. Let's take a look at these details here. So the image itself, as you can see here, it's 5,600 by 3,150. It's also 300 DPI. That's pretty large. Like there's no e-learning course that's ever going to be 5,600 by 3,150. So what I do is I take the assumption that the largest I will ever need this image, you know, maybe it's a background image, maybe it's just one of the flip cards, maybe it could be anything, but the absolute largest I'm going to need this image to be is the default size in Adobe Captivate. Now, of course, when Captivate 12 came out, all projects were 1366 by 768. You might have changed that default to, you know, 1920 by 1080 or whatever it is for you. But let's assume I'm gonna stick with 1366 by 768. So what I'm going to do is I'm gonna open this in Photoshop. And I know that Photoshop is not something that everyone has. I'll show you an alternative way to work with your images if you don't have Photoshop installed here. So let's just bump up that image there to 50% here. Just a background image of a spaceship. And I almost don't do anything unless there's some editing I need to do. I simply bring it into Photoshop, click on File, and we're going to choose Export and Export As. And this is going to bring in the interface that you see here. So first thing I'm going to do, Photoshop is really good at optimizing images. So, you know, you don't need this to be cranked up all the way. The quality doesn't need to be that high, especially for e-learning. My sweet spot for me is somewhere between 3 and 4. So let's go, and you can see a little preview here, 848 kilobytes. Now, we were talking, you know, megabytes before. We're down into the kilobyte range here. Again, if you can bring it down to 3, and you won't see a sizable quality loss, and let's reduce the size again to that 768. Now, it may not go 1366. In fact, you might want to choose 1366 in this case here. And we're down to 91 kilobytes here. So let's export that. And this is going to remove any metadata as well. So I'll just put that in the exact same location. It's saving it as a slightly different version of JPEG here. So let's just do a right click again on these files. There's the original. We can see under general here, it's 4.4 megabytes. Let's choose this other one here, and we'll just go to Properties, and we'll just bring that across and maybe minimize this so you can see the result here. So, you know, what a big difference. You know, I'm down to less than 100 kilobytes, 91.6 kilobytes versus 4.4 megabytes. And again, if we go into details here, you can see that, you know, I've gone from 5600 to 1366. I haven't even thought about this. I could actually drop down the DPI, and that might even make it smaller. But this is going to make a huge difference when you consider that, you know, if I have 100 such files, you know, it's going to greatly reduce my file size here. It's going to be tremendously smaller. Now, I did mention that there's an alternative out there. So if you happen to be, let's just change our view here so we can see which one is the original file. I'm just going to delete the one that we optimized there. There's a tool from Microsoft, a free tool for you Windows users out there. Perhaps there's something similar for Mac users called Power Toys. And once that's installed, that's going to give you some additional things that you can do from your context menu. So here's my image here. It's 4.5 megabytes in size, right? And I can go into the right click here and I can choose Resize with Image Resizer. So Photoshop, I think, does a better job. I can select one of the default sizes here, or I can choose custom and put in whatever value I wish. Let's go with 1366 by 768. There's some simple options here. Make pictures smaller but not larger. Ignore the orientation. I just turn all these on. Let's not overwrite the file. In this case, let's make a copy of the file so we can see that here. In Power Toys itself, there are some options here, like you can edit the presets here. You've got different encoding, so if you wanted to drop this down, the actual JPEG quality down to, say, 50% here. And I think that's all you probably need to do there. I don't think I need to save this. Is there a save button? No. So let's go ahead and do that resize here. Again, this is a completely free tool. It's not the same numbers before. It comes in as medium quality, but it's 218 kilobytes. And if we open this up, I want to point out that still looks pretty good. You know, like we're not really beating this up. Obviously, this is a larger image. This is at 50% and this is at 100%, so it's much smaller. But I'm not seeing any artifacts in this image. It's kind of hard because it's kind of an abstract image. But, you know, to me in an e-learning course, if this was the background of my particular slide, I would be satisfied with this. There'd be nothing here that would be of concern to me for quality.
If you thought this video was helpful, please like and share it with your colleagues. If you need help with Adobe Captivate, hire Paul for one-on-one instruction. Paul's goal is to focus on lessons based on your specific needs. Visit his website at CaptivateTeacher.com. And don't forget to subscribe to his YouTube channel.